So let's take it from which of these pieces don't exist anymore.
All right. So after you left, but before I started, Memcachedb hit a scaling wall, and it just would not go any further. The writes just were too fast for it.
Did you guys try adding more Memcachedb boxes?
I don't
know. Oh, because you weren't there for that.
Yeah.
Memcachedb was not designed for the heavy load we were throwing at. It's basically, it was the Memcache code bolted on top of BerkeleyDB, which is kind of neat, but it wasn't really kind of designed to work at kind of our scale or our use case, which was just basically sending as many queries to that as we could. So you guys got rid of this.
Right, and replaced it with Cassandra. So it's a distributed NoSQL database. The way it works is you have rows, and a row is sharded by its key to somewhere in the ring of servers. So you get automatic sharding across this entire ring. And when a row has columns inside of it, and that's where the actual data is stored. So this moved to Cassandra and was pretty similar.
Yeah, so I'll let you draw Cassandra in there, and I'll explain a little bit more about. So remember we talked about with databases, you can replicate them, where you send the same data to multiple machines, which helps for load and durability, this kind of picture here. Or you can shard them, which is you send some chunk of data to one machine and another chunk of data to another. So let's say we're talking about, in this case, we started using this for the pre-compute stuff first.
Yeah.
So you've got these listings of every subreddit has like a hot page, and that would be pre-computed. So you can store hot pages for some Reddits on this node, some hot pages for Reddits on this node, and all the way around. So each node is not an exact copy of every other node.
Right.
Now, there is some overlap.
Right, so it's configurable, but in our case, we're using a replication factor of 3, which means that if a piece of data lives on this node, it is also on this one and this one. And that happens all around the ring.
And why do you do that?
That's simultaneously, a read can be serviced from any one of the 3 if we allow it to be, which means that if one node's going slow, we don't go really slow.
Yeah.
And also, it means that if any one node just ceased to exist, we wouldn't lose all our data for that segment of the data.
Let's say you have content on this guy, this guy, and this guy, and
right.
You lose this node.
Mm-hmm.
Does the content get redistributed?
No.
No?
No. They're assigned a key space, and you have to move tokens if you want to rebalance the ring.
Okay, and that's something that you as a developer have to do?
Yeah, that's an operational
or
thing.
Systems.
Yeah.
One of the things that happens as the team grows too is people's roles change. You know, when you're a small website, you are the designer, developer, mm-hmm. sysadmin, all in one. And you guys have a whole team now of operations guys.
Two. Four. Yeah.
Okay. You have a team of two. They're
yes.
very good, from what
yes,
I've heard.
They are.
They're extraordinarily good. when I left, it was me and David, who now works with me at Hitmonk, basically developers and ops guys. And we were better developers than we were ops guys. So that explains some of this.